Hello, everybody. We're back here with some more NBA, and hopefully I don't get crushed again. But we're going to go hit ahead here and play against the Warriors. So, all right, here we go. Uh-oh. What the frick just happened? Oh, saving. It's time to set up the first scouting plan. Do you want to pick players for me to look at, or give me a general direction who to look for? I guess we'll pick prospects. I don't know who we need to get, though. Have to think here. I think it's mostly center. I think we need a center. Let's go with the big boy here. Toby Becker. Whoa. Back. Go back. Darn it, I don't know what the frick I did. There. Selected him. Okay. we'll probably need a power forward. So let's go with another big boy. Let's go with him. Wait, DE rank. 2K, big board rank. No, let's go with him. Alexander Byers. Okay. Shooting guard is who? Trevor Ariza. Small four. I might need a small four. Kyle Korver's not really turning out very well. Here we go. Let's go with him. Leonard Flowers. Got two more remaining. Let's get a shooting guard. NBA.com rank. So here's all kinds of rankings. Ooh, this guy's good. Get him. I have him ranked pretty highly. Let's look for one more center. Here we go, this guy. Cole Temple. There we go. Should we go with that? Alright, there we go. Should do good. Let's see what happens here. The frick? Going on. Hey there, T-Rock. I noticed that you haven't viewed the team intel that we have gathered on all the teams from around the league. The Nuggets? This franchise is in clearly in rebuild mode and will not be that interested in acquiring aging veterans. That's kind of true. There aren't any players that this team is dangling as trade bait. There currently doesn't appear to be any targets for this team. With the right offer, every player on this team can be had via trade. Really? Even Chris Paul? Bullcrap. Joakim Noah is on an expiring contract. Say, we're facing the Warriors. What's it say about the Warriors? This team is clearly in a buyer's market and will want players that can help it right now. There aren't any players that this team is dangling as trade bait. Both Al Horford and Paul Gasol are on the Warriors' target list. The Warriors currently have no players that they consider untouchable. Expiring contracts. Kevin Durant, Mo Williams, and J.J. Hickson. Oh, they're going to want... Oh, they got six other players, too. They're going to want Kevin Durant back. Oh, great. I'll be facing Kevin Durant. Oh, boy. Now what's happening? What's going on now? Hey, T-Rock, I just thought I'd bring it to your attention that it doesn't feel like we're pushing the guys hard enough at practice. They're all super rested and we're sacrificing our ability to improve in progress. What do we got here? Ah, crap. Just like... physical. Let's go with balance. I always like balanced. There we go. We're gonna all balance for right now. There we go. Now, here we go. Here's our game. Warriors. I guess this team's... Yeah, they were 5-6 when I looked at them before. Oh my God! I got one heck of a freaking overall. Oh my goodness. Compared to mine? They got Tyreek Evans, Kevin Durant. I guess it shouldn't be too bad. Just gotta watch Kevin Durant. Sports pregame show.
We're starting to get some early answers on this year's big questions in the NBA season. And here to tell us what it all means are the experts, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. I'm just your host, Ernie Jones.
No one's an expert.
Huh?
No one's an expert.
Well, you guys try. Tonight, we'll see the Golden State Warriors as they play against the Denver Nuggets at Pepsi Center. Well, for Denver, these guys are playing good basketball with 7 wins in their last 10 games, and they like their chances tonight. And Chris Paul will be in action tonight, and no doubt he is one of the best in the game. There are a lot of great point guards in the league, but Shaq, is he still the most complete point guard, would you say?
I would say yes. He makes his teammates immensely better with his on-point passing. Ernie, he still showed us the last playoffs that he can still hit that clutch shot.
Yeah, I still say he's one of the best on-ball defenders and basketball hawks at his position. Great all-around guard, great all-around player, and probably, I would say, one of the best leaders other than LeBron James in the game.
Let's go courtside. What do you say? Kevin Harlan has got the call.
Had a lot of nice things to say about my point guard. All right. Well, Chris Paul's always been pretty good. It's just I can't use him because I suck
it's
at this game.
It's time for some hoops at Pepsi Center, home of the Nuggets, and we're going to bring it to you live on 2K Sports. All it's right. The NBA. And
let's
it's
get this thing started.
Right here on 2K Sports. I'm
all right,
Kevin Harlan.
Here we go.
Here with me today, Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
Ready?
You look at Golden State, still trying to find that groove they had last year. They'd like to grab hold of some new momentum and get closer, Steve, to where they were a season ago.
And well, for the Warriors, they've looked decidedly average.
There we go.
In the early stages.
There's Chris Paul.
And that's shocking when you consider the kind of success they're coming off from a year ago.
Yeah, it really is shocking. I mean, they're a team with too much talent to be toiling in the
no!
middle of the pack.
Darn
it. Somebody light
don't let him score like that, Kevin Durant.
And now the Golden State Warriors
starters. How dare he.
Russell is out there with Tyreek Evans. Then there's Ryan Hollins. Then it's Robinson. And it's Durant in at the three spot. Screened by Lee.
Oh, come on. I didn't want to pass the freaking Noah.
Back to Paul. Just 5 to shoot. Puts it up from 15.
Come on, go in. Go in. Yes.
Off the rim and drops. Lee's got his first bucket of the night.
Really nice play. Your first bucket of the day.
No! Kevin Durant!
Forget about with Chris Paul is just how clutch he is.
Wait,
as a
it wasn't Kevin Durant.
Go
never
ahead
mind.
Shot in game 7 against the Spurs last postseason was a big reminder to everyone that this guy is clutch.
Here's Paul, following the basket by Thomas Robinson.
Oh, come on! I hate when it's freaking stolen like that.
Here's Evans. Good, and the assist goes.
Dang it! Come on, man.
Three assists in the game.
Off to a
Chris
nice
Paul's freaking should be a good ball handler. And, oh, no, they steal it like nothing. Of course.
So first quarter just over a minute and a half in. And a wide open look for Lee.
Come on.
Noah, the pass to Paul, feeds to Lee. Kicks it out to Paul. And there's the pass to Noah. Here's Lee up and in.
Yes, there we go.
2 for 3 from the field.
You know, guys, when you see it come together like that, I mean, that's the offensive set you want to have. Well done.
Russell kicks to Durant. Takes it from 10.
Mott.
And a
dang it.
Off the rim, but it sinks right in.
Makes on 4 tries. Everything's falling early. 100%. Can't do better than that.
Now let's find out what head coach Steve Kerr had to say to Doris Burke. Doris?
I asked him about the challenge of containing Chris Paul, and he said, well, he's one of the best in the business, maybe the best. There's really nothing he can't do. But, fellas, he said matching CP3's intensity on the
come on, Noah. You freaking suck.
Back to you.
Thanks, Doris.
Oh, come on, man.
2 free throws for the contact right there. Well, you knew something was amiss with Durant. They eventually shut him down for the entire season after he was injured, which was the safe thing to do, and Greg, the right thing to do.
Dang it!
Absolutely. When you have a franchise player trying to work back from injury, no need to try and get a few more games from him at the risk of derailing his career.
Now here's Lee. 9-point game is last outing. Out of bounds, Golden State.
Come on!
Here is a list of the NBA's most adept passing teams this season.
Oh, my God.
The Nuggets third.
You know, when your team has a lot of assists, like these guys do, it basically is a testimony to unselfish play, patience, ball movement, and player movement.
Robinson against Lee. Robinson dishes to Durant. Uses both hands to slow down.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path to the bucket.
Mm, that is how it is done.
Excellent team play there on the pick, and then he ripped it down.
Now here's Lee. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game.
Solid, solid work on the back end of that play.
Yeah, finished hard with two hands on the stuff.
Yeah, nothing extravagant, guys, but again, no need on that one.
For Durant, KD did try to return last season, but that foot just wouldn't cooperate, and that's when they had to shut him down.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty.
There you go.
Shot well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Here's Evans after Kyle Korver's bucket. Evans outside. It's Durant on the wing. Durant with another miss.
One last thing with Durant's foot. Foot injuries can be a scary thing in the NBA. Along with knees, those are the injuries you don't want to risk anything with.
Now here's Lee. He's got six. Lock at six. Ariza with the bucket.
Yes, there you go.
Ariza's got his first 2 points of the night.
And you're going to take as many of those high percentage shots as you can get.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. This game coming on the heels of their win against Chicago.
You know, they played well enough to win, but to be honest with you, I just felt like their opponent's defensive performance was shaky at best.
Yeah, I'd go along with that, Greg. I mean, the game wasn't handed to them, but they definitely didn't have to work as hard for it as they should have.
Denver with a platoon shot here on the floor.
Man, can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Now, here's Watson. He's guarded by Williams. Now Watson, taking a look at his numbers. He averages about 7 points a game. Screened by Young. But Nuggets need to get a shot off here. But three.
Shot with Bogut. Darn it.
Warriors have gone 6 of 8 in the game so far. Very solid.
Why is he
them.
Hanging around the freaking
the screen.
The outside anyways.
For three. And that's collected by Bogut.
There's some good defense for you. I mean, for somebody who's as good at shooting the three as he is, you
come
needed the
on.
Who's equally adept at guarding against it. That was
I like that. They obviously put the right guy on him.
Durant against Young. And here is Durant. 17 points for him last game against Chicago.
And he also chipped in with a couple blocks in that game. Just a hint at the impact he had on the defensive side.
Pop loose off the pick and hammers it home.
He is one guy you do not stand in the way of when he decides to attack the rim.
Watson, that's for two. Got it off in
time. Oh, come on!
Now on the court, your 30-0 Nuggets. You talk to Chris Paul, and it's clear he was born to play the point guard position.
Fortunately, I've always been vertically challenged, so I've never had to play power forward or center on anybody's team. I've been passing and getting into the lane, dishing the ball off to a teammate, helping people score my entire career.
Let's take them back.
Vertically challenged, that's classic coming from Chris Paul. But, you know, seriously, Greg, he's taken
that challenge and made the most of what he's got. A terrific play.
It really, and you know what? He's actually
turned
that challenge on his head when he goes right at much bigger players and uses their size against them.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
It's been a point of emphasis, no doubt, to make sure they attack the rim offensively.
I love the fact they're not settling for outside shots. Keep attacking that rack.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. And Golden State looking at who they've got. Durant is out there with Robinson. Then there's Avery Bradley. Then it's Williams. And it's Serafinin at the center, locking down the middle. Calathis passes to Paul. Good. Great play by Calathis to set it up. Paul's got his second basket of the game.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
And despite some of the injuries over the years, Andrew Bogut still one of the game's best shot blockers, averaging well over 2.5 a game in his career. And Greg, he protects the rim like few others can. A rugged play.
And in last season, almost 3 block shots per game. And with all the offensive firepower around him, I think it really allows him to play to his strengths. That's why having a great team is about pieces of the puzzle fitting. He's a terrific piece for this group.
Kicks it to Paul. And it's Durant with the rebound.
Dang it!
And getting back to Bogut, people forget he's a pretty good athlete. The reason he was drafted number
one. Oh my God, dude, they make everything!
Insane combination of size and movement skills. That's why he remains one of the excellent shot blockers in the league today.
Paul goes in. Ariza outside. Fires the three.
Oh, my God. Freaking make a shot!
And when you talk about Bogut, I think the Warriors' incredible regular season inspired him.
Come
on. He didn't
have
to be the star. He just had to anchor that deep. Sometimes when you give a guy a specific task to be the best at, that's what he delivers the most.
Paul against Williams. And Paul gets it to go in. Timeout called by Golden State.
Well, you know, last season, Steve Kerr came into a good situation, but a touch awkward. The team wasn't 100% on board with the firing of the previous coach, but he won them over in a hurry.
Here's what Denver's going with right now. Joakim Noah is checked in for Bogut. Lee comes in for Young, and it's Korver in for Nick Calathis. It's Noah with the drive. And it's out of bounds.
Of course he freaking loses. Of course. And Noah sucks.
Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played, Korver kicks to Lee. Cans the shot with nobody near him. Now just a 4-point Warrior lead. Greg, Steve Kerr did win over the locker room in a hurry last season. They had finished a successful run under Mark Jackson. Winning accelerates everything. They certainly bought into it.
They really did. And people don't often appreciate how difficult it is to come into a situation where expectations are that high. But he also went out of his way to empower his players and really give them some accountability. Didn't try to hide anyone on defense and played to the strengths of his team.
Give it to David Lee every freaking time. He barely misses it.
Right there, guys.
Russell dishes to Robinson. To the inside. Evans kicks to Russell. Yes, and an assist from Evans.
Come on.
Russell's got his first basket. The Nuggets trail by 4. There's 1:54 left in the first half. Here's Lee. No good.
Oh, man.
Come
on.
They got their last win against Phoenix.
And what got them that win was the
result.
from the floor. I mean, just a tremendous.
My defense is terrible.
Hey, you can't expect that kind of shooting to happen all the time on a nightly basis. But when it does, boy, does it feel good and look good.
And the Nuggets with some changes. Bellinelli, he's checked in for Ariza. And it's Watson in for Chris Paul. The Warriors also with a sub. Hollis Jefferson's checked in. Here's Lee. Can't hit.
And oh, come on! The other way.
And guys, it's easy to forget sometimes just how young.
Cars. A freaking course.
Last season, he became the second youngest player to get the 15,000 points.
I honestly can't blame myself for quitting this piece of crap last year.
Yeah, and it's even more impressive when you realize that Durant did spend 1 year in college, Kevin. You take a year off his age, and he and LeBron got to that point plateau in virtually the same amount of time.
Outside Korver. The Nuggets with another miss.
Miss after miss after miss, of course. Yes, of course. Everyone misses it.
Like him, that good a look.
Of course he makes it when I'm in his face. Of course. Freaking course.
They've gone to him. He has come through big time. You gotta keep getting him touches.
Durant against Lee. Stolen by Durant.
Oh my God, I'm getting sick of this. I'm seriously getting sick of this now.
Without question, Greg, I mean, the wise move would be to get themselves a quick shot so they have an opportunity to get that 2-for-1.
Bellinelli gets the bucket.
You know, that's a case there, Kevin, of him making a pass to a spot, and then he let his teammate run right into it. Well executed.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Hollins passes to Russell. There's a screen. Shot clock at 6. Shoots off the screen. No good off the front iron.
You can see how much the defense respects him. I mean, they were all over him on that look.
That's a 2 from Bellinelli. That'll do it for the first half. The Warriors on top, up by 7. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Kevin, obviously a very close game. What has been your approach?
Yeah, shut up.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. We welcome you to the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Kevin Durant was on fire in the first half. He had 12 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. Hey, big fella, what's your take on Golden State so far?
The bulk of their offense, Ernie, Kenny, it's come in the paint. See, it's just as good. It's hard-nosed basketball when you play in the post. Trust me, I know. You wouldn't know nothing about that, Kenny, little man.
And over to Kenny. What did you think about Denver?
Well, right now, they're getting a little embarrassed on the defensive end. They got outshot in the first half. But that's because no one put their foot down on defense to stop it. So in the second half, they need to play much more disruptive defensively. They have to do whatever it takes.
That's going to do it for now, as the second half is just about ready.
Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment.
What a performance from Durant here. 12 points and 1 steal as well. The motor on this guy is amazing. Completely revved up. He's been everywhere today.
And it's hard to say which has influenced the game more, really, his offense or his D. I mean, take your pick.
They've got Trevor Ariza. Noah is out there with David Lee. Then there's Kyle Korver. And it's Paul in at the point guard. That's the group for Mike Malone getting going here in the second half. And it's blocked by Hollins. Evans outside. In the corner, it's Robinson. The basket good off the assist from Evans. Evans has got 3 assists tonight.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
He used that pick to perfection. That's now 8 points for Chris Paul.
perfect screen there set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact that the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Russell with the bucket.
What are you going to do defensively? Such separation with the height advantage in that matchup.
Well, there may be some questions for a while about D'Angelo Russell. People will guess which position he's best at in the NBA. You and I saw him firsthand playing for the Bucks. I mean, he is a terrific talent.
Yeah, he really is. I think he's an old school guard, Kevin. He can play with the ball and be effective, or he can play off the ball. He's got a really bright future. Loved watching him play and grow as a one-year college guy at Ohio State.
Fires from 18, and he can't bank that one in. Here's Evans. Sinks that one from the post. And it's a 12-point Warrior lead.
Their second half has started quite well. They've been good on three of their first four attempts.
And, guys, one thing that stands out to me about Russell is how good he is at certain NBA plays. Very strong in the pick and roll already. Knows how to attack with contact. Great vision, and he can also shoot the basketball. And you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
And you can say this just about every prospect, but I think with Russell, he'll need some time to adjust. He has the raw skill to play multiple spots on the floor, but each position has a nuance to it that he'll need some time to learn.
Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for Denver. Young comes in for Lee. Golden State also making some changes. Kevin Serafin is checked in for Ryan Hollins. Bradley comes in for Tyreek Evans. And it's Williams in for Russell. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. For three, Durant. That doesn't go either for Durant. The Nuggets trail by 10. Ariza with it. Guarded now by Durant. Screen by Bogut. Korver against Bradley. Korver dishes to Bogut. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Bradley kicks to Durant. Can't get it to go. Good D by Ariza.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Here's Paul on the money with the shot from the left block. Paul's got it back down to within single digits for the Nuggets.
And, you know, Denver was not that good against the West last season, but they weren't as bad as you would have thought. Managed to get 19 wins against the rest of the conference, and we know how tough the West is, so that's not shabby.
Third quarter of basketball here, and just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Kicks it out to Ariza. Back to Paul. Unloads. Robinson pulls it in. Warriors leading by 11. From 12 feet out. Second shot opportunity. And it's sent back by Bogut. And it's out of bounds.
You fucking idiot.
A different look for Denver. Bellinelli, he's checked in for Ariza. Nikolaitis comes in for Kyle Korver. And it's Watson in for Paul. Hollis Jefferson's checked in for Golden State. Double team on Williams. Outside Bradley. He kicks it to Durant. Puts up the baby hook. That's good. Kevin Durant. Durant's got 14 points for the game.
Fellas, he just is struggling to get anything going. Right now, his shooting percentage in the quarter, 20%.
Watson kicks to Young. Stolen by Durant, and the call will be against Thaddeus Young. That is his first foul of the game. Outside Williams. 1:24 left in the third quarter.
You know, it was a bit of a roller coaster year for Mo Williams. I mean, he had that 50-point breakout game, but then later traded away to the Hornets.
Well, and of course, Mo Williams, Clark, shipped to the Hornets for their playoff push and helped out there.
I thought overall, Kevin, Mo had a really strong year given his age. Probably his most productive season since his early 20s.
You know, he just, like every other coach, can't stand when the defense gives up points on the inside. And boy, are they struggling in there.
Yeah, well, they're getting pummeled in there. So you've got to figure out a way to make some adjustments to try to change that around, and that's why he needed the timeout.
Watson kicks to Calathis. Young left side to stop the run. Good. That's Calathis who picks up the assist.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
And, Greg, you know nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
Outside Williams, 11 feet away, and the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. And that's now 18 points for Kevin Durant. The Nuggets trail by 16. Watson, the pass to Bogut. Young sets a screen for Bogut. The feed now to Calathis. 5 to shoot. Bogut down low. He's against Serafin, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. Denver shooting their first free throws of the game.
And 72% on the year. I'm sure they'd like to improve that category.
Guys, their free throw shooting has slipped a bit since last year, but not really to the point where they should be overly concerned about it.
Lee's checked in for Thaddeus Young, and then for Golden State. Ryan Owens, he's checked in for Kevin Serafin. Evans comes in for Bradley. And it's Russell in for Williams. Calathis kicks to Watson. Shot is good off the back rim and in.
And a sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
Durant. And released it in time, but it's off the mark. And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. The Nuggets trail by 12, and Golden State looking at who they've got. Robinson is out there with Durant. Then it's Russell. Then there's Ryan Hollins. And it's Evans in a two-guard. Kicks it out to Paul. And stolen by Russell.
Wanted to go to David Lee, but no. Stupid game passes to Chris Paul, of course.
Russell's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Warriors. And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for the Warriors.
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen.
Of course, that's who I wanted to pass to.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
Count it, and the Warrior lead has been cut down now to just 11 on the bucket from Ariza.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Hollins can't get it to go.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job. Kevin, he's been a bright spot in what's otherwise been a little bit of a struggle for this team.
Russell kicks to Robinson. Back to Russell. Inside, and it's Robinson that time on the assist by Russell. 8 points for Robinson.
Another gap in the defense found there, and they've really had their number today. And really, the Warriors had an amazing regular season last year. Just from a historical standpoint, it was one of the best ever.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. I was able to hear the advice Mike Malone gave to his team during that last break. He was emphatic. We're not getting it done, fellas. We've simply got to step up, get engaged, and try to battle back. Guys, we'll see if the pep talk gets them going.
Thank you, Doris. And Hollins with the stuff.
Oh, quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball at both ends.
Paul against Russell. From deep three-point range, and it's Paul missing. And for the Warriors last year, they would end the season with 67 wins. That number, Clark, tying for the sixth best win total in NBA history.
And my guess is only a few people saw it coming. I mean, and as the season wore on, it became more and more apparent that the Warriors were for real, but it took a while for people to accept that fact.
Clock is at 3, and it's Bradley off the drive. Noah with the block. And they'll turn it over. Could not get off his shot. 24-second violation. The Nuggets trail by 13. All up top, he's guarded by Russell. Unloads. Paul can't get that one to fall.
That's exactly how you have to defend him. He's a guy that the D needs to be aware of at all times.
Stolen by Noah. Knocks it loose. It's stolen by Bradley. And Trevor Ariza is going to pick up a foul here. That's foul number two for him. Well, taking a look at Avery Bradley, his career's been kind of up and down, Greg. Started out in high school where he developed into one of the nation's top prospects in high school.
You know, it's a great point. And as a college freshman, really established himself as one of the top defensive guards in the country, won numerous awards, then enters the draft after only 1 year.
Pass to Durant. No one near him. The shot, no good. Now Denver takes it the other way. Paul with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. Paul missing again.
You know, with Avery Bradley, he was the 19th pick in the draft for the Celtics. The outlook for him was great, but then ball handling and shooting injury concerns flattened out his development. He had a hard time getting over the hump for a few years, but he's over it now.
Paul with the three. That's good.
Yeah, perfect release that time. I mean, I thought it might get blocked, but no.
Yeah, he was giving up a lot of size in that particular matchup, but showed the excellent ability to get off that shot despite the disadvantage in size.
Noah with the block. Ariza goes in. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits.
And you know, getting back to Avery Bradley, he's been dynamite the last 2 years. He's finally found consistency with the mid-range jumper. And plays a complete game of basketball with just a little more seasoning. I really feel like the sky's the limit. And one thing that I know a lot of fans are worried about it is NBA jerseys with ads on them. It's something the NBA has explored more in depth recently and would be another stream of revenue for the league.
Russell against Paul. Pass to Noah. Back to Paul. There's the three. Warriors with the rebound. Robinson's got his fourth rebound in this one. And with the ads on the jerseys, it isn't something that would sit well with the fans probably, but around the globe, almost every other league in the world has ads on their jerseys.
You know, the NBA has shown that they're willing to try new things with jerseys, much like they've looked at other issues. It started with the sleeve jerseys, and advertisements is just another area they're exploring.
Russell kicks to Robinson. Bradley against Korver. Screened by Russell. Down to five on the shot clock. Durant just inside the line. The shot will not go. Good D by Ariza.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Paul with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. And another three from Paul.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
Russell kicks to Robinson. Dishes it to Russell. Robinson a screen on Paul. The drive by Russell. He got an advantage there off the pick and took it right in. And the Warriors lead by 10.
And they've just done a great job of keeping this crowd out of the game. And we're getting closer to victory. The crowd's getting quieter.
And there's not a whole lot for them to be cheering about anymore. I mean, their guys got it handed to them.
And he gets it to go.
And he's had an excellent performance overall from the field.
And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's his first foul. There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Nuggets foul. CJ Watson. That's his first personal foul.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now on the second shot. He's able to hit the second one, and that will put them up by 9.
And that should be enough to get the job done, even though he didn't get all of them.
7 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Watson for 3. No luck. So we see the Warriors get the win here. This was a very strong.
Yeah, I think I'm done with my GM at this point.
They'll feel very good about
it. And let's face it, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you have to feel good about it. Really an outstanding effort all the way around.
And a chance now to send you over to
the 2K Sports.
Yeah, I'm done with my GM. Screw it.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we get a chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Kevin Durant. He delivered quite a star performance. Not uncommon, as we've seen him have this sort of terrific night many times.
This was vintage Kevin Durant we saw tonight, fellas. Just tearing it up. He's got the most diverse set of skills out there. From an offensive standpoint, there isn't anything he can't do. And defensively, he can do it as well. It's almost impossible to count all the ways Kevin Durant helps his team.
I thought this performance he needed to deliver, Ernie. He needed this game. You look at how he's been playing recently, and this was huge for him to come out and have a great night. You can really tell a lot about a player how they break out of a slump. He responded exactly the way he needed to.
And folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny the Jet Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a good
one. Yeah, until I have time to actually practice this freaking game, I'm not even going to bother with my GM anymore. All it's doing is really irritating me. At least my player really, all I do, get the ball. Oh, I'm a power forward, push the guy out. Oh, I score. But not this. So, I'm done with my GM for now. Unless someone really wants to see me keep complaining about this game, I'm gonna just continue on with my player.